Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to use the Notification Center on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 500 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. The Notification Center is a very useful tool for all Mac users, but to get the most out of it, you should take the time to learn about what it can do. So the most obvious way to bring up Notification Center is to click on the Notification Center icon, which is always at the top right corner of your screen. But there are three other ways to do it, which I'll show you in a little bit. I'm just going to click there, and there are two sections to Notification Center, Today and Notifications. The only way to switch between the two of them is to click on one of these two buttons here at the top. Now the Today view shows you some information in a variety of little windows called widgets. You can use your trackpad or mouse to scroll through all these widgets here to see all the information. At the top you get today's day and date. You get a little summary of the weather and some information about calendar events for that day. Then these widgets here are all customizable. The way to customize them is to click the Edit button at the bottom. That moves the Today view over to the left, and then you see some items on the right that you haven't yet added to it. You've got minus buttons here to remove items and plus buttons here to add them. So for instance, if I don't want to see stocks here, I can click and it goes away and moves over there. I can add it back by hitting the plus button. But if I do want to see, say, the calculator widget, I can click that and it will move over. I can use these three lines here on the right to drag these to change the order so I can move calculator around. Notice the Today widget is not movable. It will always appear as the first item. Likewise, there's also a Tomorrow widget which will always appear as the last item. Now these widgets here are either here by default, such as Now Playing, Stocks, or World Clock. But they're also ones added by different apps. So you can see I have two apps, Twitter and Parallels, that have added widgets to Notification Center. You simply get those by installing those apps. You can find other apps that have widgets by going to the App Store. There's a button here at the bottom of the screen. Click that and it will take you to the App Store and show you a list of apps that have Notification Center widgets in them. So you can see if any of your favorite apps have them or if any of these look useful to you. To change settings for one of these widgets, you don't do it in Edit Mode. Edit Mode is simply for adding, removing, and organizing the widgets. So click Done to get out of that and then go into Regular View Mode, and as you move your cursor over the widget you'll see an I button to the right here. So for instance, if I wanted to customize the weather widget, I could click that and you can see here I could remove cities from it or add a new city or zip code as a location for the weather app. Then I click Done when I'm finished. Likewise, if I would go and add, say, the World Clock app, it would appear here. I would hit Done. And then I would hit the I button in World Clock and I can add a new location and then I'll get that clock there as well. Now the second part of Notification Center is the notification side. Click on that and you're going to see a list of notifications. When a notification appears on your screen, it may appear for a few seconds and disappear, or may appear and allow you to dismiss it. But it can go, depending upon how you have the app set, to this list here. So you'll see a list of notifications here. So if you've missed one, you can go to the Notification Center to see what it was and you can click on it and it will go to that app and show you that item. Now to customize what you see here, you're going to want to go into System Preferences. A quick way to get to System Preferences right to Notifications is to click this little icon here at the bottom right corner of Notification Center. You click that, it opens up System Preferences, you're right in Notifications, and now you can go through all the different apps that will give you notifications and change how they display their notifications. So for instance, if I look at Calendar, I can change things like the alert style for it. Now this doesn't change anything in Notification Center. The Notification Center control is right here. It's this checkbox, Show in Notification Center. So if there's an app that you don't want to put notifications in Notification Center, like for instance we saw over here that I got an iMovie notification, I don't necessarily need to see that and have that in the list. So I can go and look for iMovie and I could say don't show that in Notification Center. Now when I go over here you'll see iMovie notifications don't appear in the list. Now you also have a control here for how things are ordered in Notification Center. I can sort it by recents, but group them by app, or manually by app. So we had it as recents before, but if I do recents by app you can see now it puts them all in groups. So there's mail and there are the two reminders notifications grouped together. If I do manually by app, then the order is going to be different because it's going to be determined by what's here in System Preferences. So you can click and drag these items in System Preferences to reorder them. So for instance, if I want Calendar to be at top but then Reminders to be directly after it and then Messages after that, I can put them in that order. I know it can be frustrating to look at the Notification Center and see a ton of stuff listed here. It kind of makes the entire thing useless if there's too much stuff. So it's worth the time to go through the different apps here in System Preferences, turn off Show a Notification Center for the ones that you just don't need to see in this list. By turning a lot of those off, the ones that remain will become much more useful. Now if you want a good quick way to check your email without launching the Mail app, just move Mail here to the top and then Notification Center becomes the way to check your email. You can just click on a message if you need to go to it and it will open up that message. You can respond to it, archive it, etc. Now another thing that's a Notification Center in both the Today and Notifications view is a set of two controls. If I swipe down using my mouse or trackpad, I can turn Night Shift on or off here. I can also turn on or off Do Not Disturb. It's great to have an easy way to turn on Do Not Disturb. If you're about to give a presentation, for instance, you may want to turn this on so you don't get notifications appearing on the screen. Now you can also hold the Option key down and click on the Notification Center icon, and that will turn on or off Do Not Disturb. And you can see the icon here gets grayed out when I have it turned off so I can know that it's off. Now there are three other ways to bring up Notification Center besides clicking on this button here. One is to use a gesture on your trackpad. Most Mac users have a trackpad, and if you use two fingers on the trackpad and you swipe from the right side of the trackpad over slightly, it will bring it up. I find it works best if you put your index finger on the trackpad and then your middle finger just off the trackpad and swipe over to the left slightly. This will bring it up. And then you could put both fingers all the way on the right side of the trackpad and swipe off to remove Notification Center. The setting for this is in System Preferences under Trackpad and look for More Gestures. And then there's Notification Center. So if it's not working, make sure you have it turned on. This is also a good way to see a demonstration of the gesture. Another way to bring up Notification Center is to set a keyboard shortcut. So go to System Preferences and under Keyboard and then Shortcuts, go to Mission Control. Make sure you've checked Show Notification Center. By default, it's off. Then set a keyboard shortcut. So I simply set it to F1 here. Now if I press F1, the Notification Center appears and pressing F1 again will make it go away. A third way to bring it up is to use a hot corner. So if you go to Mission Control, click on Hot Corners there, you could set a hot corner like, for instance, say the bottom left to Notification Center. Now when I drag my cursor to the bottom left hand corner of the leftmost screen, the Notification Center appears. Dragging it there a second time will make it disappear. Here are a few other tricks. In the Today view, you can actually interact with some items. So for instance, in Reminders here, if I want to check something off, I can click it there and it will actually complete that reminder. I don't have to go to the Reminders app. If I type something in the Calculator app, like a calculation, I can do 2 plus 2 equals. If I do Command C, then it copies the result. Then I can go into another app here and Command V to paste. In the Weather widget, if I click on one of the weather items here, it will take me to weather.com for the full forecast. The Now Playing app, if you add it, will show you the song that's currently playing in the music app, and you have a set of controls so you can pause or move the music around, even skip to the next track. The Stocks app here, if you click on a stock, will open up the Stocks app and take you to the page for that stock. So to make the Notification Center useful for you, take the time to customize which notifications show up there, and then also customize the widgets in the Today view and learn how to use the ones that you keep. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.